Hello friends, welcome you in KK Java Tutorials YouTube channel. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about the static keyword in Java. When we want to define a class member that can be used independently of any object of that class, we use a static keyword in Java. When a class member is defined as static, it is associated with the class rather than with any object. The static keyword can be used with many places in Java programming. Like you can create a static variable that is also referred as class variable. That is the first case. Second case, you can use a static keyword before the method name, right? That is the second case. And that is also called a class method. Now third, you can create a static block. And fourth, you can of course create a nested static class. So nested static class already I have covered in the internal classes set of video tutorials. So you can go and watch. And now in this video series, we are going to cover three things how we can what's the use of a static variable, method, and a static block. But in this video tutorial, basically we'll see first of all a static variable. Next two videos we'll see a static methods and a static block, right? And there are some more use cases we'll see also. So when we talk about the static variable in Java, a variable declared as static in Java is associated with the class rather than with any object. When object of its class are created, copy of a static variable is not created per object. All objects of the class share the same static variable. A static variable can be accessed directly by the class name and does not need any object, right? So these things we will have to keep in mind. Since static variables are associated with the class, not with instances of the class, they are part of the class data in the method area, right? Now when we talk about the usage of a static variable, one of the common use of a static is to create a constant value that's at the class level and applicable to all the created objects. It is a common practice to declare a constant as a public, final, and static, what you can see over here, right? Why static? Because that is at the class level. Now second keyword I have used here, final, right? Why final? Because that value is not changed anytime. You cannot change final variable. Once you assign, you cannot change it again, right? And that's what I have declared this constant as static and final, right? Now I have a main class which static variable test, which is having a main method, and here you can see I have created a two employee object by passing employee ID, name, salary, as well as email address, right? And here you can see I'm just printing the state of these two objects, employee one and employee two. And here you can see these are the instances variable which I'm trying to print, but this is a static variable, so directly I'm referring by the class name itself, and this is a common for all the instances of the employee class, right? And that's the thing we have discussed, right? Similarly, if you look into the, when I'm printing the state of employee 2, then here you can see for employee 2 also value for this static variable would be same, right? So if I run this application, then you can see state of these two employee I'm printing, and for both of them company name is JP Morgan both, right? So value for a static variable is common for all the instances of basically employee objects, right? Now let's see another usage of a static keyword, right? So another use is when there is a requirement to have a counter at the class level Since a static variable is associated to the class and will have the same value for every instance of the class, whereas value for non-static variable will vary from object to object. So any counter which should be at the class level has to be declared as static, right? So here let's try to understand through an example. So here you can see I have a class is called counter, and I have declared a variable is called counter, and that counter I'm just try to increment in the constructor itself. And here you can see I have created three instances, right, of this counter class, and just I'm trying to print the counter this variable for every three instances. And if I run, then as we know that instance variable will have a separate config for these all three objects, right? And that's the reason here you can see this counter is printing 111, because every instance is having a separate copy. But this variable we want to treat as a counter, so that's the reason you need to declare as a static, right? So once you declare the static, right, then let's see how it works. Now here you can see counter. So as we are creating three instances of this class, so this constructor is getting called three times for every object, and this counter is basically called three times, and that's the reason you are getting value as three, and that's the common for every object, right? But there is little refactoring is needed over here. So as I said, when you want to basically refer your static variable or a static variable from your class or from anywhere, then directly you can refer by the class name itself. So you don't need to basically use a object reference. So here you can see compiler is just showing some warning saying that the static field counter should be accessed in a static way, right? So here directly we can call by class name itself, right? Here you can directly call by class name itself, right? So if I put this call after every constructor, then you can see value will start from 1, then 2, and then 3, right? Now if I run this application, then here you can see 1 2 3. Even we are not using this one, this reference. So if you want to remove these things also, you can we can remove like this, right? So we are creating three instances of this class, and when you create a instance, then every time constructor is getting called, and this counter will be incremented by 1 in every call. And here you can see value of counter is 1 2 3, and basically this counter variable is static, so that is a common for every object, all objects, and that's the reason all these three objects is basically making modification in the common variable, right? So definitely if you declare a static variable, then definitely if you are going to deploy this code in the multi-threaded environment, then you need to think about the synchronization as well. And those things already I have discussed a lot in the multi-threading videos, right? So but here we are working in the single threaded environment, so you don't need to think about the basically synchronizing this counter variable, right? So that's all. I hope you understood what's the use of a static keyword in Java with respect to a variable. In next video tutorial, we'll explore significance of a static keyword with respect to method. So that's all I have in this video tutorial. I hope you enjoy learning this video. If you really like this video, then hit on the like button. Don't forget to share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Guys, big thank you for watching this video.